It's on.
Aloha, and thank you for coming. My name is Bernadette Christensen, and I'm presenting about Hale Ohana, and it's about building a traditional Hawaiian hale. Has anybody been to or seen Hale Pili or Hapuena Heiau? And Hale Pili is actually located over at the Bishop Museum. And the Hapuena Heiau is over at Kinkamamau Hotel. And you're welcome to visit them anytime. You just can't, won't be able to enter them. Let's see. So our agenda today is on building a traditional hale is I'm gonna talk about protocol and several types of hale, and the materials used to build a hale, and the builders of a hale, and the hale as of today. First off, protocol. And what you need to do, anytime you build a hale, you actually need to have a kahuna, which is the kuhi, which is the location of the hale. So anytime you would like to build a hale, that kuhuna will need to be on site and will need to make sure that that is the correct place where this location will need to be at. You always need to check with that kuhuna first before building a certain location. Even though if you're, what the majority of the times is that you're building as a homestead. So that's why you would go through that kuhuna. And one of the main things of after you build a hale is a birthing place. And what that birthing ceremony they do is they have a celebration. And anytime you have a hale, you would need to have a doorway. And that doorway is almost like your people. So it's more like inviting people into your hale. The kahuna lono is the person that's going to be blessing that house or your hale. And that person would have a house dedication prayer for. The types of hale, or the kau hale, is the homestead, which is the hale ali'i, the hale moa. The hale ali'i is actually used for the chiefs, and they have meetings, and the chiefs actually stay in those hale. The hale moa is the men's meeting house, and the men and women cannot intermix with one another, so they normally have just the men have one house, and the women, which is the hale aina, and that would be their eating house. The men and the women do not eat together. The hale noa, which is the house free from kapu, is where the family mingles, and they sleep in that one hale. The hale kuai is the trading house, so anytime they're trading with other homesteads or other people who are selling things, they will use that hale. There's the halau hula, and that halau is anytime they're doing any type of hula or using implements or what have you, they would use it in that halau, in that hale. There's the halau va'a, and that is where they store the canoe, and that is usually located close to the shoreline, and they store the koa and mahogany. Those most of the logs are stored in this halau or this hale, so in order for them to craft canoes. The types of hale is an A-frame, and that is usually like an A-frame. It has steep roofs and short walls. usually when they build it, they use the ohia logs, and the log posts are soaked in salt water for at least a month. Thatching is another use for the hale, and what they do is they use the pili grass, and that's what they like about the pili grass is that it is sustainable and it's natural, and it has a pleasant odor when you're sleeping and just hanging out in there. Other thatching that they use are palm, pandanus, sugar cane, and the tilis. And the tilis, the thing is that when you put them in a bunch, you need at least 40 tilis to cover about a square foot. And so that's that's a lot. And that's the reason why they like to use pili grass, because you can just gather those and they're much more durable. These are examples of how they use the thatching. And what they do is they gather them up. They use a certain cordage, and they're stacked up side by side. While they're putting it on the roof, they're used to layer on top of each other, just like how we use our tiles. And it's to keep out the rain. The certain barks that they use is the olona. And what they do is they use the bark here, and they make a certain, they make a cordage. And with the long hala, they use the roots to make a certain cordage for that. The builders of the hale are the men of young and old, and what they normally do is they do a lot of the heavy work in building the hale. The children, the women, and the elderly, what they do is they're called to gather a lot of the pili, the grass, and they tie them for the builders. And they also collect smooth rocks so that they can use it as their floor in the hale. One of the builders as of today is Francis Poleni Sinenshi. And he's a builder for over 20 years. And he's built over 160 hale. And one of his goals is to train future generations. And also he uses the volunteers, the community, to help him build. And what Sinenshi likes to say, and one of his quotes is that it takes a village to raise a child, but it takes a loving mom to build a hale. So, one of the things I like to give to you to take back is a article 12 of Indigenous Hawaiian Art and Culture. And what it is that it's the requirements of what they're using to build a hale as of today, and they're up to code. And so if you would like to build a Hawaiian hale, it is something of the future. And so that you can use it here on the island. Mahalo.